So I'm gonna play some Diablo 3 right now. I already have the game running. Let's see. So I'm playing the seasonal thing. I really don't understand the seasonal thing. What I think it is, you create a new character for the Diablo season, and for that entire season. You go through the game again and you get better weapons and all that. Weapons you can't get on your regular playthrough anymore. And I think you could save those on your chest and then transfer them over to your non-seasonal heroes. I'm not quite sure yet, though. This is the first time I do it. I've already passed the game twice or three times. I passed it by myself and I passed it playing with my friend. But I haven't done I haven't done a season yet. And there's two different kinds of seasons. There's a kind of season where I think you could die and come back to life, and then there's a permanent death. And I think the permanent death, that's when you play on super hardcore and you want to see how long you could survive in the game. If I were playing that, I would probably die pretty fast, so I avoid playing permadeath because it's not really fun. At least it's not fun for me. So let's begin. I'll resume the game. I'm barely at level 7. And as you can see, not much is going on with my hero. I'm supposed to get better gear, but I haven't received any of it yet. And I can't transfer any of my old gear from the regular playthrough to the season either. So that's how they make it a bit interesting. I did turn off the music because I was hearing a different stream. Maybe I could put that to make it a little bit more interesting and make the game a little bit more fun. So this might black out a little bit, but it's all for the sake of music. So I'll play some of that. It's loading. Hopefully it's not too loud. I think there we go. Some Nintendo music. Let's do this. Let's go back to Diablo. There we go. So I really don't have many abilities right now. They dragged my car. I have a cheap-ass stomp ability that pretty much stuns the enemy. And then my right-click is, my right-click makes the enemy bleed. So, that helps right now. Is it useful later on in the game? Not really. I mean, it's fun, but...
Not enough fury.
See? There, for example. It helps out to kill the masses. It's not really that helpful in Torment. I did play using it, using that ability for a while. What do you call it again? It's called Rend. See, wound nearby enemies and cause them to bleed for 5 seconds. So it works sometimes, sometimes it doesn't. See, I have a gaming mouse, but the problem with this gaming mouse is that it's not really that comfortable.
More fury.
It feels too soft. It's a good gaming mouse, don't get me wrong. But it's just, I don't know. My fingers go to sleep pretty fast. So we have two different kind of level ups. In the beginning of the game, until you reach level 70, you do your regular level up, and then once you're past level 70, you could do your Paragon levels and you just keep leveling up the character infinitely. I believe. I'm not quite sure about this. So what I have to do? I have to find a cemetery of the Forsaken and a Weeping Hollow. Weeping Hollow. Damn, I didn't even pronounce that correctly.
I gain new strength.
I gain new strength.
During the last days of King Leoric's reign, Even the skeletons of the ancient dead could not rest. They took up their broken armor and weapons once more, ready to cut down anything that yet drew breath. Though wasted and fragile, these creatures possess a twisted cleverness that makes them quite formidable.
Still recharging.
Oh, not really. They're not formidable at all. I could kill them easily.
That creature must die.
It's that poison shit that kills me. Now when you start playing in Torment, it gets quite serious. Special effects and all that crap. It makes it a little bit hard sometimes to kill and a little bit annoying. It's not that bad when you're playing by yourself, as that is, it's limited because it's a little bit easier, but when you're playing with a friend or something, it just gets rather annoying as you start seeing them do these special abilities that can pretty much kill you if you don't move around. I understand why they did it, but still annoying. So I think I got two new weapons. Oh, damn it, I'm gonna kill this fucker. That, but it's not really that helpful. This gives me toughness and recovery, but my damage goes down by minus 1.5%, and I don't really want my damage to go down that much. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep the gear I have right now and brave it like this, with the hope that maybe I'll get something pretty good later on. Oh, my friend Rigo came online. Let's see if he wants to play.
I'm not ready yet.
Before I go to sleep. He's probably playing StarCraft.
Need more time.
I'll taste your fear.
Getting my ass kicked.
I'm healed.
These little red orbs give me life, so. Yeah, but I'm also getting my ass kicked.
Still recharging.
Die, 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 die. I think that's the closest I've come to dying so far. See what new shit I got. This is actually good. See if I put it there. 417, 1986, 2074. I think that's for the best. I also think I got some other crap. Magic chest armor, which is really nothing. So I'll go with that little knife or dagger, the magic dagger. And I'll go with my axe, and I should be able to attack faster, and that's a good thing. Attacking faster is good. Oh, sometimes when you take a long time to figure out where you have to go, the map shows you. Yeah.
Not enough fury.
Easier. What I do lose from going from the lances to the knife and the axe is range. So I have to get a little bit closer, but it's okay. And as you can see, the enemies are getting a little bit harder to kill. Let's see if Rigo wants to play Diablo. This is assuming that he's even playing. I don't think so. This isn't Battle.net, but. Send message. Dude, do you want to play Diablo? Oh, yeah, I guess he beat me. Oh, he's asking me, shame on you, you should be playing Legacy of the Void. I don't have the game, dude. I don't have the... And shame on you. You should be playing a new season with me. So I don't know if he's gonna play with me or not. Now, get out of StarCraft and get into Diablo. Man, he needs to pass Legacy of the Void first. Nope. Nope. You need to play with me, man. He says never. Well, okay, whatever. I'll keep playing over here. Let's get this. I don't need this shit crap anymore. And I'm not getting a lot of money either, so. You need to play with me. Never! I think I'm okay with what I'm doing. I don't need to play StarCraft. I'm not a good StarCraft player. And next time, I'm not gonna stay long. I have to wake up early and take Esme to work. Esme is his girlfriend, so he won't be able to. See, when you're single, you don't have to take anyone to work. You're also single. Go figure.
Need more time.
Need more time. Smack, 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 smack. Smack, smack. Smack, smack. Yeah, it's cool, man. I'm responding back to him. It's cool, man. I can play maybe tomorrow. Or maybe some other day. Or maybe on Sunday. Or you can buy a snowboard. And we can go sometime this month. I snowboard.
More fury.
Idea with the cemeteries. I mean, there's a cemetery.
Not ready yet.
There.
A foe worth killing.
A foe worth killing.
Still recharging.
So they changed the game a little bit. Originally, the barbarian you're using was supposed to be the barbarian from the first game, from the second game. I personally think he's still the barbarian from the second game. But I think they ran into some problems and they decided that instead of doing that, they were going to make this a new player, kind of give them a new backstory. But I think he's still the barbarian from the second game. So, more shit, but nothing's really good. I think Rigo's gonna log off soon. He's playing the campaign. He's not playing online, so he's not responding. That means he's busy getting his ass kicked, or he's kicking ass. He's probably kicking ass. I will be using cheat codes, so. I really suck at StarCraft. I don't know. I'm not good at strategy games.
I need fury.
You think I would, though, right? STRs or time strategy, whatever. I can't think of the actual abbreviation for the game, but so it's probably here we're at to go. Get here. Search the Chancellor's. Search for the Chancellor's altar beneath the Cemetery of the Forsaken. That might be the Cemetery of the Forsaken. Let's kill these ones. You know, if something like this really happened and, you know, the apocalypse came over here, I think we would be screwed. I don't think there's anyone alive now to kill these. We have tanks and stuff. And again, if an axe could kill a demon, and a high caliber ammunition round could probably kill a demon too.
Back to hell, dog.
And if demons did exist, what would that make of atheists? Will they start believing in it? Or
the tragedies in these lands have left many restless spirits in their wake, and they demand retribution. These spirits will take out their vengeance on any unsuspecting individual who may pass, for they believe that the blood of the living will yet restore the lives that were ripped away from them.
Not because they're idiots.
Demons have been known to devour their own young when no other nourishment is available. Their offspring, the imps, sometimes manage to flee and band together with other demon spawn. They rove in vicious packs, ready to descend upon the unwary traveler and rip his body to shreds with their tiny needle-sharp teeth.
I actually did not know that. Thank you for freaking me out a little bit more. But I'm a barb. Barbs are not afraid of anything. We just go in and kill things.
It's a trap.
It's a trap! Okay, I think that's a little Easter egg from Star Wars. Definitely is. A little Easter egg from Star Wars.
The ancients grant me strength.
Level 9. Went up 2 levels, I started level 7.
The magic is exhausted.
Ooh,
need more time.
I don't know what I did. I don't remember any of these skills. They're skeletons, they bleed.
Not ready yet. I need fury.
Come at me, come at me, you're gonna kill me.
Help,
let's
return.
Get some of these potion thingies. Usually we kill these guys in the amount of given time, you get some nice reward and stuff, but I don't know if that's gonna be possible. bitch. Leave me alone. Kill, 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 kill. He dead. And jar of soul. And usually get nice equipment when you do that. And once you're in torment, not so much, but at least right now it's better than nothing. So what does overpower do? Unleash a devastating attack against nearby enemies. I don't like that. I feel like there's nothing I can do about it. Oh, leap. Leap I like. It's not gonna help much, but at least I could jump out of things. I like seismic slam more than rend. But it is what it is. Cleave, there's a thing I could use for rapture. Enemy slain to cleave, explode. Let's try that. It makes it a little bit easier. And tools that I got. Damage goes up, but I'm sure for, well, anything I have is better, but the recovery is so low. Take one damage per hit. Oh, that's stupid. Okay, I have two, the 69, and they're both pretty worthless. The attack goes up, damage goes up, recovery goes down. They're both one-handers. You know what, let's give these a try. And let's see if it's worth it. My recovery is so-so right now. And if I attack a little bit faster, then why not? Ooh. Oh, it's arcane dust. I don't care about arcane dust. Let's get the hell out of here and let's go back. And then they're gonna explode now. I didn't see them explode. It's a bunch of lies. So I pretty much did the mission. I know I have an empty equipment slot, but that's because there's nothing that I want to use. I guess I can use this for now. Then once I get something better, I'll change it. The thing about Diablo is you want to get items that have some sort of magic on them. On them or something. There's no point of having weapons that are really strong if they don't do anything. You want them to cast some sort of elemental damage, or you want them to make you some sort of immune to demon spores or shit like that. I don't know. But you don't want to have regular weapons. Regular weapons suck in Diablo. Just because I have a weapon that does a shitload of damage doesn't mean it's that good. It's worthless. Yeah, blow. Let's go in there. Let's go kill things. Let's go kill things.
Not enough fury.
Treasure demons usually have shit, but they're hard to kill. And then if you don't kill them in time, they go into that portal.
I can't pick up anything else.
Well, we'll make sure we can. I don't need that crap.
I can't carry anymore.
I don't need that crap. I don't need that crap. Leather helm of the lion. 21. Doesn't do anything. I do need boots. Ooh. Damage goes up, toughness goes up, recovery goes up. Stay with that for now. So they got some bracers. What the hell is that? Got this one. Oh. Do it. Recovery goes down, but everything else goes up. I should have something else around here. I got something that was a bit interesting, but I don't need this. I don't need that. Anything, like I said, anything that doesn't have some sort of magical property is pretty much trash. So, back in Diablo 2, certain weapons and armor took a shitload of squares. You couldn't just put them there. Like, the helmet takes two squares. Everything pretty much takes two squares nowadays. Back in the days, not so much. It took, piece of armor could take five squares per se as an example. I'm not saying that's what it actually is. I'm just saying that as an example. Maybe back in the day, it was worth five. Now it's worth something else. But that doesn't mean anything, I suppose. Okay, I made some room. I'm a little bit tougher. I have shoes now, so I could, you know, traverse the land without getting a nail on my foot or something. So I've been playing for 28 minutes.
More fury.
I don't know what the hell that does. I don't think it does anything good.
You cannot stand before me.
Ravenous dud. Okay, let's keep fighting. I'm gonna level up soon, so probably I'll level up then leave the game. We'll see where we go tomorrow.
The ancient smile on me.
So I'm gonna play a little bit of Diablo because I haven't played it in a long time. Well, the thing about Diablo is that these caves or dungeons or whatever are randomly generated, so they're never the same twice.
The crown must be in a different crypt.
Okay. So that's not where I need to go. And he already said it's probably in a different crypt. It's probably in this one. I grow strong.
I grow stronger. You cannot stand before me!
So yes, it's this. Gain 50 additional life from death globes. Nope. Ruthless. You deal 40 additional damage to enemies below 30% health. Let's go with that. What the hell are these? I thought they were lanterns. I didn't think they were power-ups.
I need fury.
Seems like these things waste fury.
Back to hell, dog.
Now I got another monster that I need to kill. Leeches or worms inside of them, so you have to kill the worms. I think it's really stupid. Because ghosts bleed. Exit Diablo. Thank you guys for watching. But that's it for me. I'm tired. So, exit Diablo. Exit now. See you guys. Thanks for watching.